Hello and welcome back. I'm your host with the most, The Chronic Toast, and this is yet another adventure here in European Truck Simulator 2. So we've driven around Oslo and the town of Norway and discovered a remote truck dealer here. And I'd like to get my hands on potentially a man vehicle. Seems like it'd be pretty cool. We just got to driving one, excuse me. Hauling a load of stones, but we got 15 grand right here. Let's see if there's anything here that we haven't yet driven. All these are Scanias. There's another man going back up this way to Bergen, which I don't think we've been to Bergen. We have not, so that's a potential place to go. Mostly Scanias. Let's see, more Scanias. I have Echoes. Yep. So some of these are going down into Sweden. Don't really want to quite go over that way yet until we get our own vehicle. Which here after our next trip we just might do, and we'll just potentially bite the bullet and end up getting a Renault. And ooh, that one actually goes quite far. Interesting. Carbon black powder. Very interesting. So that's another man going up to Bergen, which we have not yet been to. Ooh, that goes down over to Denmark. This looks pretty cool. Honestly, that's a pretty cool top. But I think we'll stick with yet another man. Let's see, this is 360 horsepower, 12 speed, hauling tracks, 11 tons. I think we've done a similar journey before. And nothing crazy, we'll pay just over $7,000, $16 per kilometer. Looks like this will probably be a day trip, would be pretty cool. So we'll take this one and we'll head over to Bergen. And once we get there, complete this job, then we'll consider coming back, buying an Iveco, unless we can get our hands on another dealership. So we'll see how that goes. But I'm pretty stoked with the idea of getting our own truck and just heading out, either to haul stuff or at some point to actually go through and get our own trailer. So yeah, I just feel like I'm pretty high up, so. Alright, let's get this guy started here. Get the parking brake on, get our lights on. Make sure everything works. Simple stuff here in the back, but that's alright. Man, there's not even a curtain rod. Well, there's a curtain rod, but there's nothing out there. Oh, look at that sky. That is gorgeous. Let's see, what do we got back here? Oh, there's some tracks. Alright, let's take a gander. It's not a, not an insignificantly sized trailer either. It's pretty darn cool. That's pretty cool. Alright, so where are we going here on the map? Going up all the way here. Lots of windy roads. I have no idea what this is. That looks amazing, actually. Come over here, on up through. Cool. Well, without further ado, let's dive right into it and see what we can get our hands into. Cool. Get rid of the parking brake. Let's see what the buttons do. That's the horn. So let's do it that way. I'll have to figure out the map on the steering wheel here at some point. Make sure we don't clip this up here too much. This is definitely a longer trailer than the one that we just got done hauling, so chances are requires to get a little bit bigger swing outs, but that's alright. we gotta turn left here, looks like. So nothing coming that way. Alright. Bergen to the right. So I was doing a little bit of digging. Looks like there are no national speed restrictions for trucks that I could find here in I think we just made it. Yep, so there's not really any speed restrictions that I was able to find. What was really cool though is I learned that once you're going over 80 kilometers an hour, it is unlikely that you will run across speed cameras, which is pretty interesting. Looks like those are definitely only for slower speeds or within certain towns, so that's pretty cool. Like what we've just run across right here. So let's hang out here as we go through. Oh, that's cool. I bet you this place would look even cooler here in the daytime. That'd be pretty neat. Pretty nifty. E16 up this way to Bergen. And here we go. Try to climb some hills with 316 horsepower. Ooh. I like it though. This sounds really good when it's climbing. And what's cool too, I was just realizing here, is that one road we were on the last time was really heavily rutted in the snow. And here that does not seem to be the case. It's probably definitely slippery, but it looks to be a little bit better taken care of. Maybe it's because it's more of a main thoroughfare and it was plowed more. Not really sure if that was taken into factor here. Let's get this back down to 50. I think when I'm able to, I'm definitely going to get my hands on a man, at least so far. It seems really nice. I really like the feel of it. I feel fairly high up, though I know like in the Mercedes, definitely felt higher before, so that was an interesting thing. What do the gas stations look like? Pretty standard. Cool. Oh, what do we got going on up here? Something's going on. Make sure. What happened? What if the guy just got locked out, or ooh, tree or something? I don't know. But we'll leave them to their thing. Looks like they got that covered. And I have no desire to hit anyone on the side of the road. So. But yeah, definitely driving through these countries and these places and these towns, especially this time of the year when this is being recorded, it definitely feels right to have this all be nice and snowy and cold and negative 7 degrees centigrade in the middle of the night. It's kind of hard to see, but you can see some stars up there a little bit, which is pretty cool. I'm trying to keep tabs on things here. It's hard to see the trailers in here, at least on the right-hand side. So I got to get that POV mod for that field of view, or FOV, not point of view, but field of view mod. That's definitely what it is. And I'm not sure how this is going to handle what's going through here, so I'm not quite pounding as fast as I can go. You guys see that train that went by on the right? Oh, there's so many cool... Oh, look at that skyline. Oh, man. That reminds me of home quite a bit. I think there's a little bit of northern lights, or those might be clouds. It's hard to tell. For any of you out there that have seen the northern lights, when they're definitely kicking really, really heavily, you can definitely tell. It's not just kind of like this off-white little faint green. It's just bright greens and purples. Oh man, it's just absolutely beautiful. Ooh. Do not want to slide across the road there. That would not be ideal, that's for sure. So, I'll be interested to see kind of how the these maps are set up and made. I know in ATS sometimes they want you to go a certain speed around corners, or you're allowed to, and it's just not feasible with the vehicles that you're running. the scaling in the corners just aren't quite in step, and it feels like you're going too fast. But so far here, things seem pretty cool. GPS says we're coming up here on a turn. We're doing 60, we could be doing 80. So I'll try to get that up to speed a little bit. Looks like it's going to be a tighter turn coming up though. Not really sure what we'll drive it through, but I'm sure here one of these days we'll get that figured out. We got a truck coming up behind us, so I'm sure he'll want us to go faster at some point. Don't want to push it too much, but it seems like we'll do alright. Seems like it's handling just fine. Go down a gear. Don't know what that sign means. So I guess here in Norway, if you run across an unmarked side road, regardless whether it's a major or minor road, or even if it says yield, and like I have quote-unquote the straight road that goes through, I still have to yield to the one on the right if it's unmarked or if it has the yield symbol. Something with the Vienna Traffic Accords from 1968, which is pretty interesting. There's a lot of places like the UK and Spain that I'm just from the article that I read that don't follow that, so it's interesting that it's followed here, which is pretty interesting. I said that number, that word, quite a few times, but it's just when you run across different laws and regulations, especially if they're followed and adhered to, it's really intriguing to kind of learn why and how they're set up and what they're up to. Ooh, I'm coming up on a tight corner up here. And this is really, really cool to dig into that and kind of find out how different people in different places do different things. I don't know what that 1,000 meters means, so we'll find out. Maybe it's a bridge or something, I'm not quite sure. And it is just hard to see up here, so I'm going to turn the brights on until we get yelled at. Ooh, it's a little tight. Cutting across traffic, which is not ideal. Thankfully there's no one coming, but someone behind us, but we'll just have to deal with it. Ooh. Yeah, it's interesting, the physics mod that we've got installed here. Things are definitely a little bit slicker, but it doesn't quite line up with the driving experiences I've had on snow and ice. You either have traction or you don't, or you go through and you have it and then you immediately don't. I don't know, it's different, so we'll have to get used to how it's set up here within the mod, in the game, and try to adjust accordingly. But I definitely am glad that we have it active rather than just the normal pavement physics, which would be you'd be stuck to the road like glue. Something different, something unique. Tell you what, I mean, it's not a super heavy load. It's only like 11 tons, I think it was. But this hauls it just fine, honestly. Getting a little lower on fuel, but we'll dive into that when we actually own a truck and go from there. Looks like we got a left-hand turn coming up, or a 90-degree turn. So we'll see. Yep, I see the sign up there. Try to downshift a little bit. I don't have the Jake brake mapped, and that'd ideally be something that could help with this. Or the trailer brake would be even better. So here's a yield sign, for example. If someone's coming from the right, we'd have to yield. Oof, got someone right there. I don't see anyone. So let's just get out here and get going. Got a line of upset people back there, but no, it is what it is, man. Getting used to the game, diving back in. But tell you what, I'll let you guys just kind of listen to the revving of the engine here. And driving for a few minutes, and we'll go from there. Looks like we got some interesting stuff coming up here on the right, and we'll see what happens. do a hit and run. This is interesting. Tunnel run. It feels like this is going downhill, and I think that's exactly what's happening. I think we're just going underneath, and underneath, and underneath again. Oh, there's a cool truck. Don't know what the treasure was listed as, but that looks pretty neat. Should we go into another tunnel here? Yeah. Yeah, when we end up getting our own truck, we'll definitely have to have a GPS stuck up on the window. Having this big thing here on the right is just really distracting. I'd rather have something on the window that actually makes a bit more sense you'd actually see in real life, especially for some of these trucks that might not have a real GPS listed up, built into the dash, so to speak. Let's give it a little bit of juice here. Seems like we're doing all right. Looks like we'll have a sharp corner coming up here to the left once we exit. I'm curious what this will look like in the daytime. I was kind of thinking that might be the case, but I figure I probably have the time wrong. It's more than likely it's happening. Oh wow, that, even if you can't see much, that's gorgeous. Wow. Imagine being a tourist up here and just stopping somewhere and checking this out. It just looks very cool. See a little bit of lights up there. Probably coming down to a city. I don't know if that's Bergen. Don't really know. I'm not sure. Trying to keep my eyes on the road here. Oh, it's just a rest stop. Alright. I don't want to go skidding off that. That would not do. That's super cool. Oh man, and we're right down here next to the water. I'm not sure if this is a ford or what you would call it, an inlet. Okay. I gotta stop for this. It's probably gonna turn green as soon as we stop. Where's it green? Where's it red for both of us? Nope, he's coming through, so that's cool. Man, some trees out there. That's pretty cool. Well, come on, turn green. Try not to stall it here as we go forward. And immediately go into climbing a hill. I got this line of traffic behind me. That's one of the interesting things about the mods by Grimes that we have installed, is the traffic doesn't really seem to be affected, for the most part, as far as I can tell, by the Frosty mod, winter physics, and they don't really take into account the slicker roads when they're driving, so they'll stack up, they'll honk at you a little bit, but that's alright. Or they'll pass you in a tunnel. I mean, makes sense. It's a dashed line, but it's also a blind corner, man. You guys are absolutely mental. You're crazy. Oh, are we going over the bridge? I think we are. Oh, that'll be cool. That'll be really, really cool. Yeah, I just don't know that much about this region. I mean, I know it's got a lot of these cliffs, beautiful roads. Obviously, it's farther north, so it's always, a lot of times, it's cold, chilly, just a different environment. It'd be someplace I'd like to go. I think it'd be pretty neat to check out. Don't know if it'd be, you know, someplace I'd like to live or not. I haven't ever been there, so I couldn't really tell you, but... I know some people that have moved over this way, and they really enjoy it. And this is a really sharp corner coming up, supposedly. I'm trying not to blow the engine up, but I do want to get around this corner. It says 60. Okay. We can do 60, that's alright. Oh, and we're going left. Alright, let's get this slowed down. Oh, this is super cool. Oh, dude, this is nifty. I like this. Oh, man. I'm sure this exists in real life. But that's super cool. They have an intersection under... Oh, man, this is cool. That's not something I expected to see. Oh, that's cool. If any of you out there have run across something like this, where you've got weird intersections and stuff, underground and tunnels, leave a comment below or shoot me a message. I'd like to hear your thoughts about it, or what's cool, what's nifty about it, and if there's some other neat places like that here in ETS2 that I should go and check out. There's just a lot of stuff that I just don't know, so... Still fairly hard to see, but cool, very cool. It looks like we got a left-hand turn coming up here at some point once we cross. Yeah, it's still pretty misty, but that's pretty darn cool. Back down to 60. Do you see those the air movers up there? Did you see that the fan blades are moving? Oh, we're going into another one. Oh, that's so cool. That's just cool, man. Thank you. feel like I'm under modern version of Mayans of Moria. Make sure we're 60 kilometer an hour speed limit here. And I think it bumps back up after we're out here, but I'm not sure. Oh, maybe not. Got a toll booth of some sort. Ooh, it's just taking that slower. That's a big hit. Curious how they can get my stuff. Guess I gotta be in a way far. Or it's automated. One of those. It's a really cool vehicle over there. I've been driving for quite a ways. Still got a little ways to go, I think. But I'll tell you what. Oh, it's good to be back into this game. It's really, really good. Whether it's this or ETS2, once you kind of get things all set up, it just flows. And I still got a bit more to go before I get comfortable. And, you know, that's just with the driving, kind of synchronizing where things are, how they fit together, and then also all of the, the parking challenges and stuff. But it's just interesting, and it's a lot of fun to get back into this. Because you're not really sure what you don't know until you dive into a new experience. And so far with ETS2, that's what this is, and I'm pretty stoked about it. I'm curious to see what the rest of Europe is. I know they're currently going through, SCSoft is currently going through and redoing portions of Germany. I think a little bit of the UK, but it might be France. I'm not really sure. Just because those are some of the original places that they've been. So I'm very curious to see what they look like compared to this. Not only the places that they've redone, but a lot of the places that they're planning to do. I'm curious to see how it's set up. And yeah, got to get our own trailer to do that though, so we'll get to that point. That'd be pretty cool. And what's really cool too is there's a having taken a look at the speed limits, there's a variance I think of about anywhere from 3 to 4 kilometers an hour. At least in real life before you get a ticket. I'm not sure if that's modeled in game. I have a suspicion that it might not be, but there's one way to find out, and I'm sure at some point we probably will. Well, this is a cop in front of us. I have a suspicion that it is, so. I think it's still 70 through here. Yeah, that's definitely a cop. As we're going around these corners, we'll slow down even more. Because he's not doing 70, he's still going slow as well. Don't want to follow too closely, just what with stopping distances and whatnot. So if that's the speed he wants to go, then that's the speed we're going to go. A lot of these I know are also 60 kilometers an hour through here, but I don't recall if there was that sign as we went through. Don't know if that's unique just to these tunnels or if it's related to the tunnels that have the intersections on them. But we'll definitely find out. I know that these are just straight sections of guardrail they've put together, but it kind of looks like they've been dented in almost at the points where they join. And I'd like to think that it's for cars that have slid off guardrails from going too fast. nice turn. And we're going straight. Cool. Oh, look at this tree overhanging. See another truck in here. There's a lot more tunnels on this northern route. I mean, I guess it makes sense, but it's not really what I was expecting, so that's pretty cool. Looks like Bergen's coming up here, so that's pretty darn exciting. Ooh, this is a corner. Bergen discovered. Alright. Let's see where we gotta end up going. We don't have much traffic behind us and it's not stacked up, so that's a good thing. So we're gonna be turning right up here. A little bit of a blind corner. Don't want the trailer to clip. Not really sure where to go. So we'll just kind of go straight. Oh, a DAF truck dealer discovered. Okay. Interesting. That'll be another bit of an adventure is running around and trying out different trucks. So I think we have the, we've got the Renault, and then we also have the DAF now. See if we can't start out in third. I think we gotta go right up over there. So we'll see how that goes. Hopefully they don't want us to park this in some crazy location. What's cool too is I've noticed that a lot of these lights, instead of just going red to green like they do here in the States, they also tend to go yellow and then green, which is pretty cool. I haven't really run across that before. Oh, this is gonna be a bummer. Just made it. Probably should have cut that bigger. But let's see where they want this thing. Maybe we'll get off lucky. Okay, that should quote unquote be easy. Where's the play it safe? Nope. I'm a glutton for punishment, so let's go check it out. If our trailer will clear. I think it will. We'll find out. Alright. Well, let's go meander around and see what's over here. Maybe we went to a drop like this before. There's a tight spot up here, but I think we were able to get through just fine before. I just don't know if it's with this type of trailer or not. Oh, we'll be fine. Pretty sure we'll be fine here. Yep. Not a problem. I might have to do a quick pull up and back in. We'll see. How close can we get? Pretty close, actually. I think we'll get close enough where we'll be lucky. Really hugging this wall. Hey, if they're happy with it, I am not going to complain. Alright, well that was actually quite a bit of a journey. And I'm definitely liking the man trucks. They're pretty darn cool. But for that, we'll call it a day here. Lower the trailer. See what we get. Oh, nice. Level 4 newbie. Very cool. Ooh, and we get another one of these. So, long distance, we'll leave that there. High value cargo, a lot of that stuff will be fine. What does eco driving give us right off the bat? Yeah, I kind of want to start saving this because fuel costs are going to be very, very expensive at some point. But I really don't want to mess with just in time yet, or fragile cargo. High value could be pretty cool. Yeah. Trust proven experts. Yeah, that's also pretty cool. Let's take a look here. Really don't want to start tackling this stuff until the very end, so we're gonna stick with eco driving for now. Get the points into that, and there we have it. That's what we'll do. So thank you again for hanging out. It's been a little bit of a long adventure, so to speak, and I appreciate you taking the time. Until next time, I will see you later.